If most forms of sea life suddenly had nowhere to live, what would happen then? You're about to find out. Scientists just discovered something that's got them pretty worried, and honestly, it should grab your attention too. Our oceans are getting darker. Today's oceans are losing their light, and it's happening fast. This time, I'm not talking about pollution making them look murky, but actual sunlight not reaching as deep as it used to. Sounds concerning, doesn't it? That's because it is. NASA satellites have been watching something terrifying happen to our oceans for 20 years, and they just released the data. An area the size of Africa, Europe, China, and North America combined has gone dark underwater. We're talking about 30 million square miles of ocean that now look different. The weird part? It's not happening everywhere. At the same time, other parts of the ocean are getting brighter. It's like the planet is playing cosmic games of light and shadow, and we're just now figuring out the rules. Welcome back to Ocean Explorers. If you like this kind of content, please hit that subscribe button. Now let's get back to our video. There is a lot of information here, so to make it easier to digest, let's use our imagination for a second. Imagine you're a fish living in something like a subaquatic paradise. You've got plenty of food, perfect lighting, room to swim around. Life is good. But the paradise starts shrinking. Every year, it gets a little smaller, a little darker, a little more crowded. Isn't it scary? This phenomenon of oceans becoming darker does not only affect fish. The effects also reflect upon something so tiny you can't even see it. But if it disappears, we might all be in big trouble. It's not just an expression. And I'm about to show you exactly why in 30 seconds. Keep watching, because I want you to meet someone. Say hi to the silent heroes of planet Earth. When you breathe, it's partly their credit. Phytoplankton. These are tiny floating plants, so small that millions of them could fit in one single drop of water. But they produce half of all the oxygen you breathe. Every second breath you take comes from these little guys. And they need sunlight to survive. So when the ocean goes dark, they can't do their job. They can no longer smoothly produce oxygen, which means less breathable air for us. And that's not even the scariest part. The scariest part is how fast this is happening, and we didn't see it coming. Scientists thought ocean changes happened over centuries, maybe millennia. But this happened in just 20 years. Between 2003 and 2022, NASA's satellites watched 21% of our planet's oceans lose their light. Rather than gradual climate change, this is like overnight in ocean terms. In some places, the dark zones got 100 meters deeper, almost like losing a 30-story building worth of livable space underwater. And the places where this is happening the most? You'll never guess. It's not where you think. The worst darkening is happening at the North and South Poles. The places that already have the worst time with climate change. And there's more. Remember how I said some parts of the ocean are getting brighter? Well, those places are mostly near coasts where humans live. Our planet is rearranging itself. But why? Why all these adjustments? The answer involves something you probably never thought could affect the entire ocean. Like your morning cereal. Yes, even your breakfast can be connected to ocean darkness. I'll explain. When farmers use fertilizers on crops, and it rains harder because of climate change, all those nutrients wash into the ocean. Those same nutrients cause massive algae blooms that block sunlight, like giant curtains below the water. From this perspective, feeding humans is accidentally starving the ocean of light. Interesting, isn't it? And it's just the beginning. In the deep ocean, something even more mysterious is happening. Water temperatures are changing, ocean currents are shifting, and it's creating a domino effect we can't fully understand yet. Back to those fish living in their aquatic paradise, they're being forced to move. Forced meaning they have no choice. Imagine the ocean like a giant apartment building, and suddenly, all upper floors must move down. It gets pretty crowded, pretty fast. Fish that have never met each other are now neighbors. Fish that ate different foods are now fighting over the same meals. Some animals are even getting so confused they can no longer find their way home. Why? Many marine animals use moonlight and sunlight like a GPS system. When light levels change, their navigation gets scrambled. Sea turtles are swimming in the wrong direction. Whales are missing their feeding grounds. It's like someone moved all the street signs in the ocean. Even their internal clocks are messed up. Some fish are trying to mate at the wrong time of the year because their light cues are all wrong. Chaos is unleashed. Now let's move on to the next section of the video, the human connection. Keep watching because it's important. Those tiny phytoplankton I told you about, they make half of our oxygen, but they're running out of space to work. Less light means less photosynthesis. Less photosynthesis means less oxygen, and less oxygen means... you do the math. Scientists think this might just be the beginning. The data they collected only reflects the past 20 years. If the ocean can lose this much light in 20 years, what happens in the next 20, 50, or 100? Some scientists are calling this a silent collapse of marine ecosystems. Silent because it's happening where we can see. Collapse because once it starts, it might be really hard to stop. But before you start panicking, you should know that something incredible is also happening in response to this crisis. Let's bring some positive vibes. The same technology that discovered this problem is now being used to fight it. Researchers are using AI to predict where darkening will happen next. They're creating real-time maps of ocean light levels. They're developing new ways to reduce agricultural runoff. They're even experimenting with ways to help marine animals adapt. And some of the solutions are coming from the most unexpected places, like video game players. Citizen science projects are using video game mechanics to get regular people to help analyze ocean data. If you felt bad about playing video games, now you can save the planet. Gamers are genuinely helping scientists spot patterns in satellite imagery. And it's working. Some of the biggest discoveries about ocean darkening came from volunteers playing online puzzle games. And more amazing things are happening. I told you about those parts of the ocean that are getting brighter. Well, scientists are studying those areas. They're trying to figure out how to replicate that brightening everywhere else, like reverse engineering. In some places, people are creating underwater light gardens, special areas designed to maximize sunlight penetration for marine life. Others are developing new types of underwater lightning that mimic natural sunlight to help phytoplankton survive in darker areas. And some researchers are experimenting with space mirrors to reflect more sunlight into the darkest parts of the ocean. But the most powerful solution doesn't require fancy technology. Every single choice you make affects ocean light levels. The food you eat, the energy you use, the products you buy, it all connects back to those tiny phytoplankton 200 meters below the ocean surface. When you choose renewable energy, you help stabilize ocean temperatures. When you support sustainable farming, you reduce light blocking runoff. When you eat sustainable seafood, you reduce pressure on cramped marine ecosystems. And you are not alone. All around the world, people are waking up. Beach cleanups are removing pollutants that cause algae blooms. Students are designing better agricultural systems and entrepreneurs are creating ocean-friendly technologies. And everything pays off. In some coastal areas where communities took action, the ocean is getting brighter again. The photic zone is expanding, marine life is returning. It's proof that this problem is not unstoppable. But there's something you need to know about timing. Scientists say we have about 10 years to reverse these trends before they become permanent. That sounds like a long time, but remember that the current changes happened in just 20 years. In ocean terms, 10 years is like a few hours in human terms. Things that seem permanent can change incredibly fast when the whole system shifts. But humans are really good at solving problems when we put our minds to it. And this problem is bringing out the best in people. The generation that will inherit this problem is already working on solutions. Some of them are watching this video right now. Some of them might be you. And that brings me to the most important part of the story. I want to challenge you to do something. Not tomorrow, not next week, but right now while you're thinking about those phytoplankton making the oxygen in your lungs. Pick one thing, just one, that you can do differently because of what you learned today. Maybe choosing a different type of food, maybe sharing this video, or looking up ocean conservation groups in your area. Simple, small changes is how we create big changes in how the ocean behaves. And every person who makes a small change gives the ocean a little more light. The ocean that covers 70% of our planet is sending us a message. It's getting darker, it's struggling, but it's not defeated. And now, you're part of the solution, just by knowing about it. You're part of a community that cares about keeping our oceans bright. If this changed how you think about the ocean, hit that like button to help more people discover this video and subscribe if you want to see more videos about life on our planet. Thank you for watching and don't forget to share this with someone who loves the ocean as much as you do.